Hi there and welcome. I'm Răzvan and I'm a product designer here at SE Software. And today I'm gonna show you 5 plugins to help you level up that Figma game. Let's begin. The first one is Era Auto. This plugin was a game changer for me when I first discovered it because it helped me in a very simple way to connect different elements together when I needed to create a user flow or something like that. Once you have the plugin open, you will see these options. From here, you can select the direction the arrow will point, and for example, this will get you a straight line, while this one will place the arrows on the right side of the objects, and the same from this one, but on the left. Both ends of the arrow can either have a circle or an arrow or a combination of these two. By clicking here, you'll transform your regular line into a dotted one, which is super convenient and easy. The overall section of this plugin will let you change the color of your arrows as well as the opacity and stroke value, and it will let you lock or unlock the arrows so that you won't be bothered by these while working. Update positions will update the position of your arrows if you unlock them by mistake and then move some objects around. The next one is Typeout. Typeout is a library of UX copies you can use in your designs for free. As designers, we deal with UX copy on a daily basis, so having a plugin like this is really helpful. As you can see here, we have different groups with UX copy to use, and depending on your needs, you can take something from here and insert it into your design, as I'm doing right now. It is very handy and can save you a lot of time. It can sometimes happen that you forget to apply the predefined styles for text and colors for your design, and this is where Design Lint will help you. With this plugin, you can spot missing styles and correct them to ensure your designs are ready for development or design collaboration by fixing inconsistencies. And I'm gonna show you really quickly how this works. I have this frame with a button and I'm gonna run the plugin. As you can see here, I already have 2 arrows. One of them is the missing fill style and the other one is the missing text style. I will correct these two in a bit, and as you can see here, I don't have arrows anymore. Lottie Files gets you access to a library of Lottie animations for free. If you need beautiful animations for your design, this is the place to go. Once you have granted access to your Figma account, you can start to use the plugin. Most of the action will happen in the search tab, where you can browse through hundreds of animations. Tapping on something here will get you the details view, where you can play the animation and choose which file format you want. That can be either SVG or GIF. From here, you can change the background color as well. To preview your animation, use the prototype mode from Figma. Organizer is something you'll want to use when you deal with a lot of frames which have inconsistent horizontal and vertical spacings and are scattered all over the place. For changes to take effect, you first need to select the frames you need to organize. After that, you can play with the values until you're happy with them. A cool thing here is the frame minimap, which lets you change the order of your frames. If you hover over a rectangle here, it will highlight the frame on your document, and by holding and dragging, you are able to change its position. You can even add rows if you need and reverse sort order. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more.